To start a new essay in MLA format, let's start by opening Microsoft Word and then opening a brand new blank document. Before we start typing anything, let's make sure we have the right settings for spacing. If you click on paragraph settings right here, look under spacing and then choose for double under line spacing. And also, be sure to click on this little box that reads "Don't add space between paragraphs." Now, before we get started, on the top left-hand corner, let's also make sure we have the right font, usually Times New Roman, and definitely the font size 12. There are four things that should be on the top left-hand corner, the first of which is your name. The second one should be the professor and their last name. The third one should be the class name and its course number. And the fourth line should be the date with the number of the day before the month. For example, 12 March 2019. The next thing is the title, which is right below the date. So you just need one enter. And then we center our cursor in the middle. We type our title and just leave it like that. You click enter one more time to begin our first paragraph. We move to the left margin and we indent to start our first sentence. Next up is the top right-hand corner. In order to add the page numbers to our paper, we can double-click on the empty space, and then we look for the page number option, top of the page, and then we choose the one on the right-hand side. Now you see that there's a cursor blinking next to the number one. Here's where you can type your last name and enter a space in between the number. But before we take off, let's make sure that this is changed to Times New Roman and the font size 12. Now we can close the header options. And we can go to our second page to see if it worked. Automatically, our page numbers should be added, and it should maintain our last name. But before we continue, in MLA style, you don't really need the number one on the first sheet of paper. And there is an option to omit this. You can look for different first page, and by clicking on that, the document just omits that number one number on the first page, but it still contains the function to put the page numbers in the rest of the pages. Now, the last page of your paper should have its own bibliography titled Works Cited. And this usually needs to be in the center too. Right after that, you can click enter one time. You move back to the left margin and you can start your first citation. Let's pretend that we have found three articles in the library's databases and I have copied and pasted their citation onto our Works Cited page. We don't need extra spaces in between our citations since everything is already formatted to be double spaced. The most important thing about citations is their indentation. First, you should highlight all of your citations and then click on paragraph settings. And under indentation, we are looking for the special option called hanging. By doing this, you are formatting your citations to the appropriate MLA style in your Works Cited page. Notice how only the last name of the authors is sticking out on the left-hand side. And also, your citations should be listed in the alphabetical order of the author's last name. So Perun comes first, and then Silva, and then Stevens would be the last one in alphabetical order for these three authors. Lastly, notice that I did not talk about the margins in this video. And that is because you usually don't have to mess with the margins. When you open a blank document in Microsoft Word, that document already comes with a 1-inch margin. So you don't really need to modify these settings. If you need more help, please come to the reference desk. Thank you.